Welcome to Blessed Trinity Catholic Church. We offer a special welcome to all who are joining us as we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. The Mass next weekend, July 4th and 5th, will not be available on the website. Safety guidelines and social distancing must be maintained. Due to the increase in COVID-19 cases in Pinellas County, Mayor Kreisman and Bishop Parks have requested that everyone must wear a mask. In charity and to protect everyone, we will refrain from congregational singing, and while we hope that you will joyfully participate fully in the Mass, we ask that you please make your responses quietly behind your masks. For communion, we ask that you prayerfully consider receiving in the hand for the protection of all. The Eucharistic ministers will come to you. You may use hand sanitizer prior to receiving communion. When the Eucharistic minister reaches your pew, lower your mask, stand, and remove gloves if you are wearing them. After consuming the Eucharist, you should replace your mask and kneel or sit. The ushers will not take up a collection. There are baskets at the front and side doors for your offerings. After this dismissal, we ask that you please follow the directions of the ushers so that we may have a safe and orderly exit from church. Father Wayne has sent a letter to the sick and homebound of our parish regarding mass attendance, spiritual communion, and Eucharistic ministers to the sick. If you know of someone who should receive this letter, please call the parish office during the week. Each week, we are welcomed by our fellow sojourners as we gather together to celebrate the Eucharist. Today, we hear of a woman and her husband who offer hospitality to the prophet Elisha whenever he comes to their city, going so far as to furnish him with a place to stay. Let us furnish a place to stay in our hearts for our Lord to stay so that we may gain strength and nourishment on our journey to the kingdom. At this Mass, we remember in our prayers Anthony and James Salata, so that we may celebrate together as brothers and sisters in Christ. Please stand and welcome our visitors and one another.
God, serve you the Lord, heart filled with gladness. Come into God's presence, singing for joy. All the earth proclaim the Lord, sing your praise to God. Know that the Lord is our Creator. God is our Father, we are His own. All the earth proclaim the Lord, sing your praise to God. We are the sheep of the green pasture, for we are God's people, chosen by God. All the earth proclaim praise to God.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. My brothers, my sisters, the Lord be with you. Thanks for coming. And before I forget it, we have to do something very, very special, otherwise they're going to get killed on the spot after Mass. There is a special birthday blessings for a beautiful lady, Harriet Anzek. Sounds Polish. Sorry, my Polish is not that great. And today she's only 95 years of age, just a baby. So we can give her a nice blessings, and I'm sure she's going to continue to live another 100 years, and then she might go back to the Creator, okay? That should be enough, don't you think? God of all creation, we offer you a grateful praises for the gifts of life. Hear the prayers for our sister Harriet, your servant, who recalls today the day of her birth and rejoices in your gifts of life and love, family, friends, and fun. Bless her with your presence, surround her with your love, that she may enjoy many happy years, another 100, all of them pleasing to you, right here in sunny Florida. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Harriet, this is just for you. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We pray for you during this liturgy, and you pray for us for the rest of your life. Remember, another 100 years, and then you may go. Well, if you want 150, you got it.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison,
Christe eleison,
Christe eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie. To God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, O Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us.
God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand up in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the second book of Kings. One day, Elisha came to Shunem, where there was a woman of influence who urged him to dine with her. Afterward, whenever he passed by, he used to stop there to dine. So she said to her husband, "I know that Elisha is a holy man of God. Since he visits us often, let us arrange a little room on the roof and furnish it for him with a bed, table, chair, and lamp, so that when he comes to us, he can stay here." Sometime later, Elisha arrived and stayed in the room overnight. Later, Elisha asked, "Can something be done for her?" His servant Gehazi answered, "Yes. She has no son, and her husband is getting on in years." Elisha said, "Call her." When the woman had been called and stood at the door, Elisha promised, "This time next year, you will be fondling a baby son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Of the Lord I will sing forever. Through all generations my mouth shall proclaim your faithfulness. For you have said, "My kindness is established forever." In heaven you have confirmed your faithfulness. Forever I will sing. Blessed the people who know the joyful shout. In the light of your countenance, O Lord, they walk. At your name they rejoice all the day, and through your justice they are exalted. Forever I will sing. Splendor of their strength, and by your favor our horn is exalted. For to the Lord belongs our shield, and the Holy One of Israel our King. Forever I will sing the goodness of the
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Announce the praises of him who called you out of darkness.
listen to his wonderful light.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Whoever loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever loves son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. And whoever does not take up his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Whoever finds his life will lose it. Whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Whoever receives you receives me. And whoever receives me receives the one who sent me. Whoever receives a prophet because he's a prophet will receive a prophet's reward. Whoever receives a righteous man because he's a righteous man, we receive a righteous man's reward. And whoever gives only a cup of cold water to one of these little ones to drink, because the little one is a disciple, amen, amen, I say to you, he will surely not lose his reward." The Gospel of the Lord. Whoever does not take up his cross is not worthy of me. Whoever receives you receives me. In Italian, when you want to identify something which is almost like impossible, we say the expression, but you say, "La croce, la croce, la croce, troppo pesante. My cross is too heavy. Let's do something about it." Well, you know what? The more you complain about the cross is too heavy, guess what? The cross is going to get worse and worse by the minute. So I would just say, why don't you ferme la bouche, that means accept the cross the way it is given to us at this very moment, and you would be very happy. If not today, tomorrow. Promise. Today, listen to Jesus' words. Whoever loses father or mother more than me is not worthy of me, Matthew. We cannot help being taken somewhat, almost like, what? I still have to love my mother and my father. So I was told when I was just a kid, before getting to pre-K. However, if we think over these words a little more intensely about it, we may discern the lesson our Lord Jesus has given to us. That is to say, for the true Christian, you and I, God and his kingdom are the only absolute reality. You have to understand that part. Each person must first discover his or her own vocation. Maybe this is the most delicate task to carry out. And he or she must remain faithful to the vocation, which might be for me the priesthood, single life, a religious order or letter of mercy for you married people for years and years and years, and don't change your minds. If a Christian has a matrimonial vocation, like most of you here, he or she must realize that carrying it out certainly implies loving hers and her family as Christ loves his church. So, in a sense, from time to time, you might say, yeah, that's my cross. Well, you were married 50 years ago to your best man, and now after 50 years being together in holy marriage and matrimony, you want to change your mind? Shame on you! Continue to love each other until the Lord is going to call you to Paradiso. Okay? I think I'm going to stop right there about today's gospel story, because then I'm going to say something about two great, awesome saints which we will celebrate Monday. And since Monday you're not going to go to church, most likely, maybe just a few of you, like myself, and Giovanni here to my right, and we celebrate a solemnity. St. Peter and St. Paul, they are they're actually patron saints of the city, one of my favorite cities where I spent 5 years of my precious life, Roma, in Italia. The Pope is in Roma. So we pray to the Pope because we celebrate the feast of the patron saints of the Roma, and the Pope is there, so we pray for Papa Francesco. Okay, don't forget it, today and Monday. We would probably go to confession to Peter, I would say so, sooner than maybe Paul or the other ones. I wonder why. Yeah, there is a reason. He is a more striking example or simple fact of holiness and much forgiveness from the Almighty, because he did say, remember, before Jesus went to die on the cross for you and I, you are one of them. You are one of them. Three times, and what? What are you talking about? Oh, my dead body. I never met the guy in my life. And then he went outside, he cried like a baby for the rest of his life. That's St. Peter for you and I. Jesus says to us, as he said in effect to Peter, it is not you who have chosen me, Peter, but I have chosen you. Peter, the rock, the foundation of our church, it is not a human wisdom that makes it possible for you and I to believe, but my Father's revelation. And I, not you, built my church upon the rock. Peter, the first pope, or 266, if I'm not mistaken, popes we had in more than 2,000 years of our Christian era. And guess what? Because he was a Christian, because he loved Jesus so much, in the year 64 AD or so, they killed him. Yeah, what's it raised the Vaticano? The hill, 170 years of Roma. And they built a big, huge basilica on the top, St. Peter Basilica. Awesome, beautiful place. You should go there and visit. Well, not today. Wait a few more days. Oh, whatever. I mean, don't ask me. I'm not a prophet. I'm just a little priest. And yeah, so he was killed on the cross. And he asked, before he was killed on the cross, he asked the Roman soldiers, do me a favor before they kill me. What is it, sir? Can you put me upside down? Because I don't want to die just like my master. And the Roman soldiers, no big deal. We will do just so. We're going to kill you anyhow. So they killed him on the cross upside down. The year 64 AD. Now, the other guy also went to Roma, obviously, to bring Christianity. Paul, he was a persecutor, and then he became a great lover of Christianity, a fantastic preacher. Of all the preachers in 2,000 years, I think Paul is the best. Paul's experience of the risen Jesus on the road to Damascus, you know what happened? Yeah, he fell down on his rear end. He hit the dust all right, and the horse was happy about it. Imagine. And he became blind for 2-3 days. So finally he said, you know, who are you? That you, well, I am Jesus, and that you tried to persecute me and my followers. Shame on you, Paul. And Paul said, I'm sorry. I will do something about it. Guess what? He did. So the driving force that made him one of the most zealous, dynamic, full of life, full of zest, courageous ambassadors of Christ in the church who ever had. And there is no one actually greater than Paul. But guess what? Persecution, humiliation, weaknesses, even death, because of his day-to-day care on the cross, material for further transformation. The cross, sure he had a cross. He went to Rome, house arrest for 2 years, and guess what? In the year 67 AD or so, not far away from the Tiber River, there they killed him on the spot. And they say, that's a tradition, I don't know if that's a true story, that the head went on the grass 2-3 times, and there was water there, went all the way down to the Tiber River, I hope. The dying Christ was in him. The living Christ gave to him life, zest, and reason over there in heaven. So I will repeat again what I just said from today's gospel story to make my point about la croce, la croce, la croce. And don't complain to mama and papa, because they ain't going to listen to you. Whoever does not take up his cross, Whatever the case might be, in our nowadays wear masks. I don't like either, by the way, but that's a cross. You can laugh about it. Okay, he came after me, is not worthy of me. Whoever welcomes me, my brothers and my sisters, is a lover par excellence, is a Christian, is a Catholic. Well, with that in mind, my brothers and my sisters, let us continue our journey toward heaven in Paradiso, one of these days. Take your time, though. Don't go too fast. Amen. Amen to that. Thank you, John. He knows me. My brothers and my sisters, let us now believe in one God. We say the profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For as men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. But the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and seated the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, apostolic church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen, amen, amen. My brothers, my sisters, my friends, we take the opportunity now to pray for all our needs, wherever they are, and for all those in need, trusting everlasting goodness of the Lord, our God and Savior.
Our response will be, Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the church, that we may always be willing to take up our cross and follow the Lord no matter the cost, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all those who provide leadership in government, in the workplace, and in the family, that they may shepherd their people along right paths and treat with compassion all who struggle or stray. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those most affected by global warming, those without resources or ability to overcome the effects of natural disasters and environmental repercussions, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those anticipating the birth or adoption of a child, that they may know God's blessings in welcoming a new member to their family, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all of us, that we may grow in willingness to offer hospitality to those in need, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the sick, especially those affected by the coronavirus, and for all caregivers, that they may know Christ's healing power and love. For the deceased of our parish, and for all the faithful departed, and for those for whom we wish to pray in the silence of our hearts, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. For our sister Harriet, we just bless at the very beginning of the Holy Eucharist that today she turns to be 95. May the Lord Jesus give it to her another 100 years at least, and then she will go back to heaven, to Paradiso. We pray to the Lord. Lord, graciously hear us. Lord God, we sing of your goodness. We bring these needs before you now. Listen to our prayers and grant them according to your holy will. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
to the seashore, neither searching for the rich nor the
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, your mighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good and good of all the Holy Church. O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we now pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of these sacred gifts. We ask all this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is true, right, and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks and praises, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state. By his suffering and cross, conceal out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened up the way to eternal life and salvation. By ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so now, with a company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises, as without end we now acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy,
indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we now pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Deus meus et omnia. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray to partake of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Papa Francesco, Gregory Bishop, the other bishops, our priests, our deacons, our religious men and women, in a very special way, the ones belong to the Order of Letter Mercy, like myself. We pray again in a very special way for our two friends, Anthony James Celata, for whom the celebration of the Eucharist has been offered right now. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy upon us all, we pray. With the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, bless Joseph, her spouse. The Blessed Apostle Peter and Paul, we will celebrate in a very special way Monday. And the other apostles, Andrew, St. Peter and Olaskar, the founder of the Mercedarian, and St. Anthony of Padua, Padua, my patron saint, the other saints who will please you throughout the ages. We may merit to be coerced to eternal life. May praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
And the service commanded from by divine teaching with that to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait our blessed hope at the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. I only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
By the hungry heart with gifts.
cup we bless and share. The blood of Christ outpoured, do not one cup, one loaf declare, our oneness in the Lord. You satisfy the hungry heart with the gift. Lord, no mortal tongue can tell, whom all the world cannot contain, comes in our hearts to dwell. You satisfy the hungry heart with the gift of finest wheat. Come, give to
bless the Lord, O my soul, for all within me is holy name. Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we've offered and received fill us with your life, O Lord, we pray, so that, bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit to last forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May blessed Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. My brothers, my sisters, the celebration of the Eucharist is over. Yes, the lady has the last word of wisdom.
I would appreciate it if you would let the ushers come and escort you out. They will be coming from the back to the front, so if you please stay in your pews until they escort you out, and so we can keep everything at social distancing. I appreciate that. Thank you very much.
Hey, ciao, everyone. Hey, remember la croce, la croce, la croce.
Now thank we, O Lord God, with heart and hand and voice. graces, who wondrous things hath done, in whom this world rejoices, who from my mother's arms has blessed us on our way with countless gifts of love, and still is ours today. God, throughout our life be near us, with ever joyful hearts and blessed peace to cheer us.
Bye-bye.
Receive us in His grace and guide us in distress and free us from all sin. All praise and thanks to God, the Father now be given, the Son and Spirit blessed, who reigns in highest heaven, eternal triune God, whom earth and heaven adore, for thus it was, is now, and shall be.